If you want the best speaker points possible, don't make it a theory.
My AC is pretty fair.
Unless you're like running a textuality shell and trying to exclude a non-textual position. I mean, that's,
You're willing to adjudicate theory.
Yeah.
If we.
I adjudicate theory just like any other art.
Yeah, I just wanted to double check, nothing had changed.
Like, you don't know what, if you like, don't know what you should do other than theory and you need something wrong, like, yeah, I'll vote off theory. Just your speaker points won't be as good.
Alright.
Except I won't vote off, I won't listen to AFC to justify the criterion.
Thank God. Even when I'm half, I think that is terrific.
I'll listen to it to justify, like, excluding discourse arguments and stuff.
Yeah, I think it probably makes sense as a role of a valid argument.
Yeah.
It probably doesn't make sense as, like, app gets to specify whether
the
student has an app.
That's the only argument I won't listen to.
What's up,
Jared?
I'm ready when you are.
I know Boyer springs from my cousin. Do you know Rachel too?
I don't really know her.
But you know Sam.
Yeah, Sam.
Sam, the up and comer.
Yeah, he'll be.
Arguments about violating law of the Constitution be nothing further affirming with judgment and laws make that rule consistent with them. Felonies are crimes of which punishment may be death or imprisonment for more than 1 year. Set that definition, saying, terms, eight offs, ignite times, two shifting. Then you see evaluation forces the 37 restart, 1 year, and that's what it is, more B, because neck and death link the arguments to have definitions. Arguments about the harms of adult or punishment are welcome because juveniles have already been charged with violent felonies. This places on the adult system, and neck will do because juveniles can only be charged with delinquencies in the juvenile system. Bayham writes, adult court punishes people for their lawful conduct. Emphasis in juvenile court is on rehabilitation of child's lawful conduct. Juvenile court of child's lawful conduct is called the delinquent act. A child felt guilty, adult court is not delinquent, but is convicted. On the other hand, the child adjudicated juvenile court is not convicted of a crime. One juvenile adjudication involved, the adult court considered conviction. Further, treated as has not been treated with normal means, laws, for some facilities for juveniles or arguments about placing juveniles with adults are relevant. Additionally, even if treated as means exactly the same set of facilities, treated juveniles and adults exactly the same grouping, each with its own age and the same standards, grouping likes. Likes also necklace demonstrate a relevant difference between juveniles and adults to justify distinct treatment. They may not just argue that a whole bunch of physiological reasons that neither. Adults nor juveniles should be treated by the system, and therefore should be treated the same as law enforcement. This argument is why juvenile system is good, but I take no why adults would be harmed by it. It's morality. The criterion is maximizing citizens' rights first. Treating people's sons by other means of price is the greatest amount possible for an impartial decision maker. Rakowski writes, the core conviction behind this ends on these principles that human beings are equal viable. Individual status is more equal, wise than other people kept alive and maximized. Only this way can give way to a quality of personal life or destiny. You can share fears to chase of people's less valuable than others. Decision making mistake. More discrimination should best go. This is special to your proportionality. Focusing on proportionate punishment presumes the importance of the divine price itself. But allowing more disproportionate harms to get race violations if it's articulated as a second state. This also controls the internal link, the contracts, arguments, and the constitution. People rationally would consider the utilitarian system because maximizing the probability they get the very individual law of aggregation is not regarded one to value or own interest. Second, the government is the actor because it oversees criminal justice as far as usual because the government is created by citizens for the protection of citizens. He writes the government, so it's a civil obligation to protect their interests. Even if females cannot, Russian self-reflecting supercharges the obligation forces the government to protect them through its own analysis. The anthropology is bad because it fails to prescribe action to deter purposes of state policy to manage between conflicting risks, but the anthropology makes this impossible because the rights well as complex as uses and guide governments. And the act of mission distinction is irrelevant in government policy because it was guiding role both authorized outcomes, so the only question is to relevant to government's sense of renewal. Government is in the business of granting permission and prohibition when explicitly imposes the authorized action. It's not making to do anything or refusing to act. However, the distinction between authorized and unauthorized and private action, for example, private killing becomes secure in the government formally for his private action, chooses a set policy that not adequately discourage it. Thus, I advocate juvenile charge of violent felonies arbitrary as adults with respect to capital punishment. I reserve the right to clarify. I contend the age-based distinction and death penalty produces bad outcomes. The ban on juvenile death penalty is grounded in international precedent that kills the court's independence. Dan writes, Jesus is Robert's liking looking at foreign law for support to looking at regarding picking up friends. The point is not that foreign law is or is not appropriate. The key question is how to practice really judicial independence, the principal function of independence, and the ancillary judgments for public opinion, all by ignoring external pressure for judges. We should legally stand to conclusion that controlling foreign law is controlling public opinion. The free to say the investigation is enforcing the death penalty against juveniles other countries will look with disfavor. This is no different from proposing that a judge should resolve disputes to prevent Congress or activist groups from looking with disfavor. And juvenile death penalty is especially key to spring issue that determines future President Bradley writes. Juvenile death penalty may have broader implications related to the U.S. and international law litigants are seeking to build on the success. Juvenile death penalty has become central to this effort, and the way challenges are resolved in this context may have a significant impact on other attempts to investigate international law. But transitioning democracy's model or independent judiciary independence is key to their successful transition, CJA. Strong independent judiciary is essential to stable governance in emerging democracy countries that successfully transition to stable democratic forms of government by means of judicial review by strong independent judiciary. Others have suffered the rights of oppressive rulers to consolidate power by diminishing the role of the judiciary and still others hang in the balance and shed their threat and bless emerging democracies consistently look to the United States' constitution and fashion frameworks to safeguard the independence of judiciaries. Establishing judicial review by strong independent judiciary is a critical step to stabilizing and protecting these new democracies. Conflicts in Egypt and Libya supercharged to link democratic transitions are key to preventing many scenarios for extinction. Diamond writes, life under the Peter's increasingly endangered. Most of us are aggravated by the weakness or absence of democracy with provisions for accountability. Democratic governments not able to cleanse their own population, not will build weapons of mass destruction used on one another. Democratic countries are more reliable, open, and enduring trade and partnerships. They are more environmentally responsible because they must answer their own citizens who organize their very best to honor international treaties since they value legal obligation because their openness makes it much more difficult to breach agreements in secret. Everyone's deterrable. The only question is accessing that level. Yaya writes, many non-economic studies in the show of punishment does not deter crime. That this is not evidence of lack of deterrent by their emphasis and penalties are not high enough. If we deserve the penalties so far, have not had that effect. This is not evidence of rationality on deterability and thus their ability to reason justifies the higher punishment. Yada yada too. No one has suggested that welfare that viciously attacks humans should not be dealt with harshly simply because animals have less capacity of reasoning and acting, less ability to reason suggests punishment should be increased. If juveniles are risk over their proper crisis of crime should be set higher and harsher sentences to her. Juvenile practices and weirdly proving yada yada three. As juveniles transition into adulthood, no matter by the age of majority, crimes committed by the new adults are negatively influenced by wealth and harshness. The cities where adults are punished far more severely than juveniles, when juveniles reach the age of majority, violent crimes drop. The cities where juveniles reach the age of majority, 17 and new adults commit less violent crime than 17 and new adults commit less. The cities where age of majority, 18 to write just as rise into the sentence of punishment as adult, 60% increase in juvenile crime could be attributed to drop in juevenile punishment. And the death penalty generators appear excluded. My evidence says interjurisdictional data, but the constant time frame was not biased by non-analogous control group from making the strongest evidence available. Yada 4. Zimmerman looked at city level data from 1970 and offers that there is a deterrence effect of age execution, reducing average 14 hours. Shot as a prevent, did not matter whether the murder was done by passion or murder by infamy, but other crimes usually can be undeterrable. They're also reducing the presence of execution. 91% of states is offended the death penalty following the U.S. Supreme Court moratorium execution in 1972 said the state's very recent increase in the murder rate, so 70% of states have reintroduced the death penalty after the moratorium saw a drop. It turns out we specific isn't because it controls the internal links often for offenses and means people don't go to jail or recommit so I garner all their offense. Additionally, I access recidivism in Mexico states don't consider because fewer people will ever enter the system after families and serving jails. Those people will commit more crimes as well. Additionally, all their evidence assumes the world without the death penalty, the reoffending will be low in the afterworld because multiple sentences can trigger death sentences people won't do. Presumption permissibility go up because we also publish training people's moral equals have to take a reason not to. Additionally, go up because in that context, even if there's substantive reason, they go to the disadvantage of affirming, denies the fairness of the substantive interpretation requires a firm finding absent. Like a reason that game generates an obligation to affirm because our harms in the air of the status quo that we cannot be complicit with, and thus are obligated to make an attempt to decrease and thus I affirm.
Yeah, that's fine. If you want it for prep, though, I'd prefer to flash it through.
All right. Cool.
Yep.
What is the thesis of the AC?
I advocate that the age-based distinction in terms of how we apply the death penalty to juveniles and adults is bad.
What does that mean?
It means that however we ought to apply it to one group, we ought to apply it to the other.
Okay, so are you advocating doing affirming the resolution in a holistic sense or just in terms of the death penalty?
You mean, am I whole res or a plan? I'm happy to be either whole res or a plan, with the caveat that the arguments in the AC framework contextualize what it means to be whole res. For example, the argument about ought being desirability, so the feasibility of whether you can actually implement the policy is irrelevant, for example, would frame stuff as, like the Hockaday NC that says it's literally impossible to treat juveniles as adults. That argument, while they might think it links to whole res, is contextualized as outside the scope of the resolution as per
so other than the odd definition, what else would link into that?
Every argument above the value has some function, right?
So what does that mean? What does it mean if you could be a plan or a... So if
what
you
do you mean?
Plan,
like, I'm trying to be as fair as possible. I'm not trying to be like, I could be either. Whichever one you choose, I'll go the other way. What I'm saying is,
Some teams run, must run a plan.
So you will defend the resolution in a holistic sense, but you are hyper, like if I say, can we defend the resolution, can the app defend the resolution?
Would you like me to defend whole
yes.
res, Jared?
Yeah.
Okay.
All
right. I will defend whole res.
Okay.
The arguments in the AC frame what it means to be whole res.
All right.
Not in the sense of the advocacy state.